No one that I know has had the kind of personal sexist nastiness that Julia Gillard's had to endure.
Whether you agree with her politics, whether you agree with what she's been doing in the parliament, whether you agree with some of those speeches that she's made, the one thing that I don't think anybody could disagree with is that she is one tough lady.
I will not be lectured about sexism and misogyny by this man.
They say some of them were hateful and vitriolic, and they've demanded an apology.
Tim's gay.
Well.
No, that's not me saying, that's a myth.
Well, that's absurd.
Where women are demeaned and have invasive questions like that asked, I think that's a society which diminishes all of us.
There are people out there who are objecting to the fact that there is a woman in that role. So I don't care who's in that office, Labor, Liberal, man or woman, you need to respect the office of Prime Minister.
I think that when it comes to misogyny and gender issues, the national debate in Australia is at a fairly low level right now.
Because of social media, people are anonymous, they can tweet whatever they like, and so you're getting a really unfortunate discourse in Australian politics, which is mean.
I'm constantly shocked and amazed at some of the things that come out, some of the attacks against the Prime Minister, and I think that the menu was a perfect example.
I think unless you call it as it is, and you say small breasts, big thighs in a red box, you cannot get the enormity of that offensive abuse. We didn't see any reference to a male penis on a skewer or anything, did we? No, we don't do that with men.
In Australia, I think there is a sense that, you know, yeah, just say what you mean, mate. Like, there's no need to wrap it up in a pretty bow tie. If you want to say something, say it. He's just being himself. I don't think you can get away with that to the same extent in the United States.
Women sort of have to be women first and politicians second, whereas men can be politicians first and men second. So a woman is not allowed to seize power. That's something that men do, not women.
She is constantly referred to as Julia Gillard, the person who knifed Kevin Rudd. I mean, there are lots of other men who've knifed their predecessors to get to where they were. But they're not referred to, and they were not constantly referred to during their prime ministership, as the person who knifed their predecessor.
And the government will not be lectured about sexism and misogyny by this man. Not now, not ever.
I thought the misogyny speech was really one of the high points of her tenure. So I think it's something they're going to teach in universities. I think it's something that they're going to, that is going to be closely associated with her her tenure. And I think for good reason.
The success of it was because it resonated with a whole lot of women who had the same sort of innuendos and unfair treatment at work.
But I actually had an argument in the parliament with, I was on one side of the chamber, female Labor politician on the other side of the chamber, and yes, it did get heated. And yes, we were raising our voices to each other. It was the last time I did it, because that was reported in the newspaper as a catfight.
Why would young, passionate women who care about issues think about a political career when they've seen this happen to the first woman to become Prime Minister of this country?
I think it would be turning all people off going into politics at the moment. It's a 24/7 news cycle, constant scrutiny. Everybody's under constant scrutiny.
In 20 years' time, there'll be enough of us who will say it was incredibly unfair. And then we'll say, oh, well, someone had to be the trailblazer. Well, that's just not good enough for me.
I think people will say, wow, you know, she was handed a, or rather took a sort of rudderless, no pun intended, ship, and, you know, turned it around to the greatest extent possible.
The key point in this debate is that we shouldn't be having it. The key point in this debate is that we should be talking about the things that matter to the Australian people, and that is the policies, the direction, the vision that our political leaders have for this country.